people with unusual, unloved, unknown animals, reptiles, amphibians, invertebrates. We do kids and adult shows. But I got a little departure there from the norm today, a new program I put together. I got the Jungle Bob moniker by trade, actually. I've traveled 34 times to tropical forests there. So Bob Smith suddenly became Jungle Bob. Somewhere along the line, my kids coined that name for me. It kind of stuck. And it's appropriate. And of all the trips I've taken, certainly none has changed my life more than my three trips to the Amazon River Basin. This is where it's really happening, folks. This is where the conservation movement should be focusing. This is the largest tract of land on the planet that is still unspoiled. I do kids' programs primarily. I'm glad to see a room full of adults. I've been dabbling with adults and seniors lately. It's going over like gangbusters because they really have never seen anybody like Jungle Bob, and I'm talking straight information to them, but I'm not talking beat you over the head, the world is, we're failing, and the planet's going to pot, and there's pollution in the environment, we're cutting it down. I'm taking a different tactic with that. I'm trying to show people the beauty of all of nature. The kids I show, my other unloved, unusual program, I show them tarantulas and snakes. Oh, you guys really head for the hills when I do. But the kids love that kind of thing. The adults, I've seen a lot of them. I did a senior citizen up in Emma Clark a couple of weeks ago, and I had a 94-year-old gal, so I made her. She never did this before in her life. I let her handle a tarantula and a snake, and it really was a touching moment for me and her, I hope. So I got this Majesty of the Amazon, Majesty of the Amazon show, is what we're going to show today. Technical stuff is always confounding me, so I got my partner here, Susan, who's going to figure it out, I'm sure. We're going to show a little video about it we put together by piecing it off the internet and grabbing some footage of that we took in the Amazon. And I got a PowerPoint presentation, and it wouldn't be a Jungle Bob live show without some live animals. I only got 15 minutes, so I only got to bring one with me just to show you. I show the kids representations of animals that come from this area. But with the adults, we also get into some other cool stuff. We have an Amazon herb company that is sponsoring me. Amazonian herbs are some of the most potent botanicals on the planet. They come from this fantastic place, the Amazon Basin, where the water, the air is pure, the soil is virgin, and the plants that are growing from there, we've long known, have turned into some of the drugs we use today. I'm a big advocate of not using those drugs and using the plants instead. Why go to the drug if you can use the actual plant? In our lifetime, this wasn't really available with companies like Amazon Herb. It is now available. You can actually ingest this stuff directly. And it's a tremendous anti-carcinogenic, antioxidant type of products that are really have changed my life physically and health-wise. They really are wonderful. When the adults are in the room, we pass out samples of tea and chocolate, which everybody seems to love. It's very nutritious and healthy for everybody. And then we get into some of the indigenous people talk, because certainly people are part of the forest as well. So it gets up there at the adult level. When the kids are in the room, we kind of skirt past that and go mostly toward the animals and the fauna. That's what they like to see. But the adults really like to see about the peoples of the land. I've collected quite a few really interesting artifacts in my travels, bows and arrows, blowguns, and things of that nature. So we pass those around, let me experience it, and make people understand that the people in the forest are part of the forest and part of the ecosystem. Okay? How are we looking? Gee, that was good. Okay, so we'll look at a 4-minute video, then I've got a PowerPoint, I'm going to go through it, I've got to run through it. It's at least 60, if not 90 minute presentation, depending on questions and answers. But please enjoy. If you can kill the lights, maybe that'd be good. Thank you. case. That's just like a little warm-up. It's a little teaser of all the things we talk about in the PowerPoint presentation. Put the lights down. I'll do that right there. Just flip into it, Susan, if you would. Just let's get going, because we only have a couple of minutes. Again, we're talking all about the different aspects of the Amazon. It's an extremely educational slideshow that we put together here, because it talks about the geology, the ancient history of it. It's talking about, of course, the flora and the fauna and the indigenous people. But it's really going through every aspect of the Amazon to impress upon people how important it is. I've been to these concerts, and I've been to black tie affairs that are saving the rainforest, and so many of them are disappointing to me in that the vast majority of the money collected goes to administrative purposes. There are some people that are out there actually taking care of the forest and understand it, like my friends at the Amazon Herb Company. This is the most important place on the planet. It's the source of most of the fresh water on the planet. It's absolutely the source for the oxygen we're all breathing today. It all emanates from this one place. The Amazon Basin, people don't understand the scope of it. I've flown over it and been there three times. It's approximately the size of the continental United States. So we can impress on kids and adults equally that if you look at the continent, pick up a copy of the Amazon and put it over on a map, the United States, it's like walking into a forest here in Suffolk County and coming out in California. That's how big it is. It's going to take an awful lot of people to try to destroy this place. Yeah, we're doing the best we can, I guess, to try to cut it all down. But again, with the children in particular, we are talking about, not about the destruction of it, we're talking about where it came from. The basin, a lot of people don't understand, a lot of the books I've seen, unfortunately, are very outdated. The basin actually came, it used to flow, the river, it used to flow westward towards the Pacific Ocean in ancient times. And then something happened, the continents came together, the Andes were created. The Andes pushed up, created a gigantic lake right in the center. And as these magnificent mountains went up and up and up due to the continental plates coming together, this vast river system reversed its flow and went out into the East Coast. Along the way, it created an incredible amount of tributaries that, you know, the Amazon always gets second place to the Nile River in terms of the length. But it's not even close in terms of the volume of the water and the amount of different rivers. If we can hit that slide, I think it's the next one. Well, I'm kind of jumping around there. Let's go back to this. Highest concentration of life on Earth, 70% of all the plants. You can read some of the statistics. Let's move on there again. I wanted to get to the one about the types of rivers. There we go. Black rivers and white rivers. One more time. We'll click away. There we are. The river itself is 4,100 miles long approximately, but 15,000 rivers feed it. And seven of those are actually longer than the Mississippi. So now people, particularly adults, are getting their arms around the scope of this thing. Only a foot deep in certain places, but it's approximately 350 feet. The delta, I tell the kids, is 2.5 times longer than Long Island. That's where it exits into the Atlantic Ocean. It's an incredibly wide river. When it exits out of its 4,000 miles, the water that's shooting out of that last one really hits home. 8 trillion gallons of water per day pours into the Atlantic Ocean. Every hour, more water pours out of the Amazon into the Atlantic than New York City uses and consumes in a year. Every hour, more fresh water shooting out. So here we're always worried about the reservoirs and what have you, and all this fresh water is going out into the ocean. It's created a silt bar all the way out into the continental shelf. It drops off 35,000 feet. So there's some fantastic statistics here about what this river system is. I'm not going to walk in front of it. We certainly love to talk to young and old alike about the canopy. That's very, very important information in schools. Learning about the rainforest, you have to learn these keywords, and we get into that in depth. Lungs of our planet, we only have 5 minutes to go to scoop. Lungs of our planet are producing the oxygen. People that understand how important the people are there, the indigenous people are being slowly acclimatized into Western civilization. The plants and things that we get from there, we have samples of these. Still being discovered species, scientists on the ground trying to figure out what some of these products do. The camu berry, one of my favorite, 80 times the vitamin C of an orange, in a little tiny fruit that grows like a cranberry, now available commercially in the United States for the first time. Really good if you have a cold. Mammals, abundant wildlife. We have all types of mammals, butterflies. There's more bird species in a square acre of the Amazon than there are in all of the east coast of the United States. So we can throw out statistics that are not meant to be bragging more than they are to impress about how dynamic this location really is. And jungle Bob has been known for his reptiles over the years, but really, I'm an animal lover of all types, so we are bringing other types of species into the room. We have a bird now that we can talk to. We talk about birds in depth. People want to get into that. There's more bird species here than you ever want to talk about anyplace else. 1/5 of all the birds on the planet are on this, in this Amazon forest. There's the 20% number. Mammals, we can move past that because everybody knows pretty much what they are. Those are the ones people can key on. The big cats, the monkeys, certainly more primate species there. A month ago, it's not, I don't know if it was in the libraries, but I read scientific journals, there was 10 new frog species found in one little section of the Amazon. They're finding new species literally on a weekly basis. When it comes to insects, 95% of the insects haven't even been discovered yet. So a vast area that is teeming with life. When it comes to reptiles, certainly that's Jungle Bob's favorite. And I never disappoint young and old alike by bringing somebody with me. So I have a little snake along. This is a snake that is indigenous to the Amazon, a boa constrictor. I'm a hands-on guy. I bring the Purell so the moms don't get upset with me. We walk around the room, let everybody handle the boa. Actually a very, very docile creature that doesn't want to attack people and swallow them like you see on television. What else we got? We go past reptiles. We've got about 3 minutes. More fish species swimming around this river than there are on the whole Atlantic Ocean. That's kind of an incredible statistic, and some of them reach tremendous sizes. Can feed the whole planet if we wanted to. And when it gets into the insects, another thing I love to talk about, because there are more beetle species in the Amazon than there are all other species of animals on the planet. Just beetles. This thing's going up my shirt. Last time I had to keep going to a striptease, but we're going to do it today. Okay, I'm getting constricted while we're talking. There it is. We touch at the very, very end. We throw a few shots out there. People don't understand what deforestation is. There it really is. There's people cutting down the forest to plant soybeans. There's a worldwide phenomenon of soybeans are filler. They're supposed to be really good for you. But this is what they do to the land. That was all virgin forest before. This is what it ends up as. So we hit that. I like to go over that with the kids. I don't like to harp on it. But with some of the adults, we have to make them understand. That's where a forest used to be, not this little tree. So I'm going to need a volunteer to come help me get the snake out. As soon as this is over. Otherwise, it's going to be tough to drive home. How we doing? Exactly right on time. Okay. Any questions for me? Again, adults and seniors. I'm offering $375 for my trip. Time's up for my show. And anybody that books it the next week, it's $350, $25 discount, which you donate to the rainforest. Okay? Yeah, that's my last comment. If you can read that out loud to yourselves, I think that's kind of Jungle Bob's mission statement these days. Let's not look at this deforestation and the loss of rainforest as something we can do nothing about. If we understand beetles and snakes are important, maybe a handful of people committed can really change things. So thank you for your time.